there are specific laws that we have that protect the weaker sections, particularly the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes. Unfortunately, in many instances, we find that these laws are either not applied or they are not applied competently. I think today we have found that in many instances that we have heard, the state authorities, the police, the administration has sometimes not only not applied these laws and given justice to those who deserved it, but in fact acted against them. I think we've heard some horror stories that really ought to be mainstream and should be heard by a wider audience. The people of India should know what it is that the reality of Dalits and Adivasis is in this country. Some of these cases will illustrate this very clearly. The focus of our media and of national politics is on relatively minor issues. We talk about, for instance, Islamist terror, which outside of Jammu Kashmir kills people in the single digits every year. Less than 10 Indians die of Islamist terror outside of Jammu and Kashmir in a population of 1.1 billion every year. But the amount of coverage that this gets is disproportionate. Whereas if we look at the deaths and the murders and the rapes and the atrocities on our own people, on the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes, these numbers go into the hundreds of thousands. I think our ignorance of this and our deliberate looking away from the sheer numbers is a crime. I think that as a nation, we ought to be more focused on the crimes against our own people and bring the focus back to where it should really be. I will have to say that a lot of the action that is being taken from the ground up comes because of human rights defenders and from civil society. Politics, mainstream politics, seems to be divorced from this, and it should not really be the case. I think the same sort of activism that we see from much smaller groups like NCDHR and the idea of human rights activists in communities picking up these issues, these should actually be the issues of mainstream politics. It should be the BJP and the Congress and the state parties everywhere which should be picking up issues at the village and neighborhood level and talking about them. This is not the case. What is happening is certain cases come to light, certain cases get justice because of activists and not because of popular politics. But if the domain of popular politics is the voter, we really should be looking at cases of the individual. Politics should be invested in this sort of thing. When Indian citizens are murdered, they are raped, they are discriminated against. We heard stories today about temple entry. We thought this was a story from the 1930s, for God's sake. Gandhi went on a fast in Gujarat in 35. It's been 80 years. Has nothing changed in this country? And if it's not changed, should it not be the subject of mainstream politics? It is not. It is the fact that it is the activist and the human rights defender who brings up these cases to the spotlight as and when they can. Mainstream parties tend not to talk about this, and that is shameful. There is a very kindergarten definition of development that politics has appropriated. I think the definition is slightly more mature. No advanced country in the world has become advanced, has become developed without individual rights. The idea that individual rights is divorced from development is not only a lie, but it is laughable. It is stupid to think that we can take land away from people without their permission and to have in that same sort of country development in our cities. That's not going to happen. It hasn't happened anywhere in the world. Nowhere in the world has a state that has neglected the rights of the poorest and not given them education, not given them proper healthcare, not given them safety, has become a developed nation. If Indians think that we can become developed or advanced or wealthy while neglecting that half of our population that doesn't have any of this and has no recourse to any of this, we are living a dream. It is challenging to work in a part of the world where, on the one hand, you have a wonderful constitution, a very liberal set of laws, very modern mechanism in terms of written law. But on the other hand, you have every possible sort of human rights violation in all parts of the country. This is unique to India. I think that you can either have places where you have a very good set of laws and a relative lack of human rights violation, for instance, in many parts of Europe, or you have human rights violations on a large scale and no set of laws like you have in China. I think India is unique in that we both have democracy, a liberal constitution, but also very grave human rights violation. To operate in a place like this is similar, that we have many supporters, thousands of supporters who stand with us on the issues that we believe in, who campaign on our behalf. But it is also true that it is there are certain difficulties in working on things like the death penalty, in working on the rights of minorities, because in our politics it is often felt that this is something that is akin to pandering to them, which is untrue. I think we see all our citizens as being the same. Unless all our citizens have access to justice, unless all our citizens have access to healthcare and to education of the right sort, we will not be able to develop.